Hello guys, welcome back to part 34 of Double Homework Episode 5. I'm a Skitty DK, let's go.
Damn, Tamara is smart. I don't know how I'm going to pull one over her. I wish I knew what to do about Johanna. I'm just pacing up and down the riverfront, thinking about the sweet situation I'm in. That's when... that girl, sitting in the cafe. Is that... no, it can't be. I've never seen her with her hood off.
Oh, damn, she's cute. She looks like a little angel.
Wow, she's pretty. I wish she was like this more often. Her blue eyes, cute freckled face.
Holy shit, don't sneak up on me like that.
Sorry, I was just...
it's creepy, just stop staring.
Sorry, I didn't mean to. I didn't recognize you at first, that's why I was staring.
Yeah, I get it. I hardly take the hoodie off, so I suppose it's normal.
But, you know, you look good without it. I think it would help your personal branding if you showed people your face.
I mean, I guess.
Emmy was really defensive when I saw her with her hoodie down. I wonder what the story behind it is.
People just tell me I'm pretty all the time. It's not like I don't like it, it's just... something I don't know how to react to.
I guess that means I shouldn't compliment her appearance then.
I actually didn't realize I had my hood on. I wasn't thinking about it.
It's pretty hot, so how can you wear a hoodie in this weather?
My blood runs a bit cold. I'm shivering from temperature, if you can believe that. That being said, I don't usually go out when it's this hot.
So you'd rather stay inside than go out without a hoodie?
Yeah, basically. I spend so much time inside that I force myself some outside time each day. 30 minutes is usually my goal. I suppose that's kind of weird for you, being an athlete and all.
At one point in my life, I wouldn't have been. Now I completely understand it. It's predictable in your room, safe, you don't have to deal with people. I mean, everybody has their own deal. Some people are inside people, some people are outside people. I don't know if I should say this, but given your lifestyle, I'm a bit surprised to see you aren't, well... fat.
I've got good genes, I guess. Blessed from birth.
She doesn't sound happy about that. Well, if you're scheduling outside time, it might as well be screen face.
I was reading a book.
Yeah, on a screen. Why don't you need a normal book?
This is the 21st century and we don't have to pop trees anymore to read.
Trust me, I'm not one to lecture people on good habits, but I know you need at least a little time not staring at flashing rectangle.
Well, I agree in principle, I just don't know what else to do with my time. I mean, what? Take a jog? Hike? Ski? No offense.
What's wrong with those things?
For as long as I've been alive, I've been easily bored. Jogging, walking, doing nothing, my mind races. I just want to keep occupied, you know?
Not really, I like physical exercise. Makes me feel good. Clears my mind.
It didn't even do that for me. I mean... my physician always tells me that I should and shouldn't do. I never took his advice and things always turned out fine. You must live in a totally different world from me. Exercising every day, sticking to schedule, eating gross health food. It's going to the Olympics, work their freedom.
Never thought about it like that before.
I don't know.
I suppose I keep doing it because it never seems like work. The feeling of being healthy, light on your toes, getting up and being on top of the world, it requires sacrifice. But you don't have to lose your freedom.
That's an interesting perspective. I gotta get back home. I have to do stream in 10 minutes.
Kinda sounds like you to have no freedom.
Yeah, right. Sorry, I overreacted when you saw me. You surprised me. But... if you feel like closing it up a little, you should come hang out. I can force you to follow me on Twitch.
Yeah, I might like that. Wait, before you go, I need some advice from you.
Shoot.
If something weird happens between you and a friend, and the friend pretends like it didn't happen, what would you do? It's driving me crazy that I can't get her to open up about it.
Her? Is this a romantic thing? Things got a little out of control? Misk, he talk. I guess it means you did sleep with Lauren.
No, not that.
You were blushing a little. But it's gone now. I was partly right. About what? I don't know. Just confront her directly. That's all I have to say.
I guess I could try.
Goodbye, Miski.
Goodbye. I definitely don't want Amy thinking I'm taken. Or maybe I do. A lot of girls prefer men who have partners. I'm getting ahead of myself. I don't even know if I'd want a relationship with her. I don't know yet.
Yeah, you should make up your mind. I mean, come on. Put yourself together.
Where is that camera again? Who are you? What do you want? I spin around and shout in an empty alley. Is that her? It can't be. I don't think I saw her at the club, but it was dark and busy. Different journalist or not, she's still the same breed of piranha paparazzi. Come out here! Oh fuck, she's gone.
Who are you shouting at?
Yikes, Tamara! She has a whole bunch of bags next to her, bearing the names of different boutiques. Retail therapy?
Don't say that. I hate that term. Retail therapy. But yeah, I was bearing shit. Buying shit, sorry.
Now, who were you screaming at?
I have a journalist trailing me.
Don't call them journalists, they're paparazzi.
She's gone now, anyway. What did you buy?
You like my new clothes?
New?
Yes, new.
Very the same as before.
Oh my god, you really are a dude, aren't you? It's a licorice shade rather than a charcoal shade, and these are chrome rather than gunmetal studs. I decided I wanted sort of a 50s greaser / bike gang vibe, I mean...
I don't understand.
I'm updating my look to keep up with microtrends. Like how one shade of black becomes more popular than another shade of black, but it's basically still black.
Sounds stressful. Why not just throw on a t-shirt and shorts, call it a day?
Basically, you're hopeless. Why are you pacing outside the apartment?
Pacing? I wasn't pacing.
Yeah, it's like you're afraid of to walk in. Please don't tell me it's Johanna again.
Well...
Here's what you have to do. You have to go to her room and confront her directly. Lay on the law. Damn well make her tell you what's going on. I know you locked yourself in your room for 3 months, but you can't keep avoiding people. I hate it, I'm the one to tell you this. I'd better just let you flounder. But it's getting annoying with you whining over time.
You're right, Tamara. I do have to tell her.
And no delays. You tell her right now.
Yes, of course I will.
Alright, let's just prepare confronting her.
I'm very curious. Right?
Right. I need to talk to Johanna. I won't let her get out of this one. I'm going to fix our relationship, whether she likes it or not. She's just beyond this door. I can hear her typing. I won't really be interrupting her. I'm sure it was waiting on her too. Second thoughts immediately start rushing through my head, but as the door creaks open, I know I'm in it now. There is no way she won't notice me. I have to do this. It's too late to turn back. Johanna.
Hey, Miski, could you knock first?
I wasn't thinking, but that's because I'm angry at you.
Angry at me? Why?
I'm not actually angry at you, but... I don't know how I feel right now. Frustrated, maybe.
Is there anything I can do?
Yes, you could. Acknowledge that we kissed.
Oh. I thought if we didn't talk about it, it would just go away.
It was super weird. I'm your friend and I'm getting kind of flustered thinking about it. It was a stupid thing to do and we shouldn't have done it. And I have no idea how or why it happened.
I'm sure things like this happen all the time.
I don't know, maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. Point is, it's bothering me. Talking about it does make me feel better, though.
Well, I'm glad, friend. I just care about you a lot and I didn't want this coming between us. That's why you pretended like it didn't happen.
To be honest, it wasn't like the kids that bother me, it was just a lack of communication. We both sit on her bed. I start rubbing my eyeballs. They itch with half tears. I can feel the salt build up, making them red.
The kiss didn't bother you.
Of course it bothered me, but if we talked about it, at least we would know what it meant.
What it meant?
Yeah, aren't you curious about what it meant?
I thought it was an accident.
Have you ever had an accident like that?
No. But you feel right. And it did mean something.
That would be super weird.
I mean, what could it mean? Maybe we were stressed out? And it was just a way of releasing tension? Or...
Nothing else comes to mind. But that isn't true. Something does come to mind, but I don't want to even contemplate it. It would be too weird, especially for us.
Is it that important that you know why it happened?
I think it is, so I guess we should...
I mean, there is one way of finding out.
And if nobody else finds out what we did?
It would just be once, and then we wouldn't talk about it anymore, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's try it. I'm going to come closer, okay?
Or should I put my arm around you, or...
If I could just squeeze next to you.
Am I holding you or are you holding me?
Do we have to hold each other? Let's just try it.
Okay.
So guys, I think I'm gonna close the video here. I hope you enjoyed and see you in the next video. Bye!